In our discussion on DNA molecules, we mentioned that DNA is the biological molecule that stores the genetic information that is found within the cell, and the DNA molecule are found inside the nucleus of our cell. Now, the genetic information that is stored within our DNA can be used to ultimately produce and synthesize our proteins and enzymes that are used by the cell. However, the DNA itself is not directly involved in protein synthesis. Instead, our DNA must first be transcribed into a molecule known as RNA. And it's the RNA that is directly involved in the synthesis of our protein molecule. So in this lecture, we're going to basically differentiate between RNA and DNA molecules. And we're going to discuss the different types of RNA molecules that exist within our cell. Now, what exactly is RNA? RNA stands for ribonucleic acid, and RNA is very similar to DNA in that it is also a polymer that consists of individual units known as nucleotides. And just like in DNA, our nucleotides in RNA also consist of three important parts. We have a sugar, we have a phosphate group, and we also have a nitrogenous base. Now, let's begin by differentiating the type of sugar that exists in DNA and RNA molecules. So recall, in DNA molecules, the sugar that is involved is the deoxyribosugar. And this sugar looks something like this. Notice that on the deoxyribosugar, the second carbon does not have a hydroxyl group. However, the RNA molecules contain the ribose sugar. And unlike the deoxyribose, the ribose sugar actually does contain the hydroxyl group found on the second carbon. So this is the ribose sugar that is found on RNA molecules. And that's exactly why our RNA stands for ribonucleic acid, while DNA stands for deoxyribose nucleic acid. Now, let's move on to our nitrogenous base. So there are four different types of nitrogenous bases that are found in DNA. So we have guanine and adenine, which are the two types of purines. And we also have the thymine as well as our cytosine. And the thymine and the cytosine are the two types of pyrimidines that exist in DNA. Now, RNA nucleotides also contain adenine, guanine, as well as cytosine. However, thymine is not found in RNA molecules. In RNA molecules, the thymine is replaced with the uracil nitrogenous base. And the major difference between the thymine and the uracil is the composition of atoms. So notice this carbon contains the methyl group on thymine, but this carbon does not. And this carbon contains the nitrogen, the amine group, while this carbon contains our carbon-oxygen double bond. So this is the major difference between the thymine and our uracil nitrogenous base. So in DNA molecules, we have the thymine, but in RNA molecules, the thymine is replaced with our uracil. Now, recall that in DNA, the thymine combines or pairs with the adenine. In RNA, the adenine actually pairs with the uracil because we no longer have the thymine. So in RNA molecules, our adenine pairs with uracil while the guanine pairs with our cytosine. Now, what other differences exist between our DNA and RNA biological molecules? Well, another important difference between DNA and RNA is that RNA exists mostly as a single strand. So we do find double-stranded RNA molecules, but our RNA molecules predominantly exist in the single strand form. However, recall that DNA molecules actually exist predominantly as the double stranded form. So we have our double helix. Basically, in DNA, our two single strands of DNA align anti-parallel and they hydrogen bond to form our double helix, but the RNA exists predominantly in the single strand form. And this is exactly what allows our RNA molecule to actually pass through the nuclear pores. So unlike DNA, which stays within the nucleus of our cell, mRNA molecules can actually move from the nucleus to the cytoplasm through the nuclear pores that are found inside the nuclear membrane of the nucleus. Now, as we mentioned earlier, there are different types of RNA molecules that exist, and each one of these RNA molecules serves its own primary purpose. So let's discuss the different types of RNA molecules and what their primary function is. And let's begin with the messenger RNA or mRNA. So within the nucleus of our cell, our DNA can be transcribed. It can undergo a process known as transcription, which we'll discuss in detail in the next several lectures. And DNA can be transcribed into our messenger RNA. Now, messenger RNA, once it's actually formed, it can be modified in several important ways. And ultimately, our messenger RNA will end up in the cytoplasm of the cell, where the messenger RNA will combine with the ribosomes of the cell, and the messenger and the ribosomes will basically combine to synthesize our proteins. So we see that the ribosomes can basically translate the genetic information that is stored within the mRNA, and using that genetic information that came from the DNA, we can synthesize our proteins through a process known as translation, which we'll discuss in much greater detail in the next several lectures. Now, in eukaryotic cells, our eukaryotic mRNA is usually used to synthesize a single protein, but in prokaryotic organisms, a single mRNA molecule can be used to synthesize many different proteins. Now, let's move on to the second type of RNA, known as rRNA, which stands for ribosomal RNA. Now, ribosomal RNA is synthesized in a specific section of the nucleus known as the nucleolus. And once we synthesize our rRNA from the DNA, that rRNA can transfer into the cytoplasm, and it can combine with special types of proteins to form the ribosomes. So we see that ribosomal RNA are specialized RNA molecules that combine with proteins to form ribosomes. So ribosomes contain RNA, and RNA basically form an integral part of these ribosomes. And recall, in our discussion on ribosomes, we said that ribosomes are the machinery that is used to synthesize our proteins. And finally, let's move on to the final type of RNA, known as tRNA, which stands for transfer RNA. Now, when our mRNA combines with the ribosomes, what happens is our mRNA contains a three-sequence nucleotide that is known as the codon, and the codon basically stands for some type of amino acid. Now, in order to bring that amino acid from some location inside our cytoplasm into the ribosome, we have to have some type of molecule. And the molecule that brings the amino acid into that ribosome is our transfer RNA. So transfer RNA are specialized molecules that collect the proper or appropriate amino acid and bring it into the ribosome, where that amino acid is then attached to the growing polypeptide chain. So we see that all three of these different types of RNA molecules are synthesized inside the nucleus, and they're all involved in the process, in the synthesis of our proteins. And each one of these different types of RNA molecules serves serves its own unique function. So the messenger RNA basically contains the genetic information, the codons, that basically code for our protein. The ribosomal RNA are integral parts of ribosomes, which are the machinery that basically synthesize our proteins, and the transfer RNAs are those RNA molecules that collect the proper amino acid and ultimately bring it into our ribosome so that we can add that amino acid to the growing peptide chain. So we see it's not the DNA molecule, but it's the RNA molecule that is directly involved in the synthesis of our proteins, and we'll discuss the processes of transcription and translation in the next several lectures that involve these different types of molecules.